the fundamental challenges for police services to work within the framework of data protection. We have to be innovative, we have to be very, very creative, and that is where we have to build on for the future.
Every year, the conference of the Europol Data Protection Experts Network allows professionals from the academic world, the legal field, non-governmental organizations, students, civil society, and members of law enforcement to come together to exchange knowledge and discuss the access and the use of personal data within the field of police operations.
Desde una perspectiva jurídica es muy importante abordar una aproximación multidisciplinar a uno de los derechos fundamentales de las personas, una regulación que permita alcanzar un equilibrio entre el acceso a los datos personales con fines de seguridad ciudadana y el derecho individual a la intimidad de las personas.
Its 11th edition was held in Madrid this past 18 and 19 of September, organized by the Academy of European Law and Europol, with the collaboration of the Guardia Civil taking part of the events scheduled for the Spanish Presidency of the European Union. The opening conferences were given by the Executive Director of the Guardia Civil, Mr. Leonardo Marcos Gonzalez, the Executive Director of Europol, Ms. Catherine de Bolle, and the European Data Protection Supervisor, Mr. Wojociech Wieviorowski.
So we took the effort to come here to take part in this discussion.
In addition, it has had the assistance of the police data protection officers from 24 member states of the European Union and the intervention of several speakers of different nationalities which are experts in the field, such as Mikko Iponen, Rick Ferguson, Hiroshi Miyashita and Daniel Solov.
The main objective for this event is to understand that data is the most valuable thing in the world right now.
In this edition, it has given special importance to the dialogues developed in relation to data retention, body cameras, artificial intelligence, big data, and of course, the role that data protection officers must play in supervising that everything should be done respecting the right to data protection contained in the Charter of Fundamental Rights of the European Union.
We are confronted with AI tools. We are confronted with large translation tools. We are confronted with quantum computing, so we have to find a way how to use it.
All in all, in this kind of meeting, technological, scientific and legal knowledge go hand in hand, promoting progress in the fight against crime through a multidisciplinary approach, maintaining the high standards in the protection of fundamental rights that characterize the European Union.